Well, looky what I got. Fella brought it to me. A trucker delivered it for me from Montreal. And it's got, I hope it's got good rod bearings, and it's got good cams. I need cams. They're $200 a piece, so that's $400 worth of cams to buy new. And these ones look, they're reasonable. They'll be all right. And I needed rods. That's quite a bit more again, $100 a piece. And I needed a timing cover. And this comes with all the covers. Chromed, nice shape. It's been gutted as far as the primary. There's nothing in the primary. And I got one broken fin on the cylinder, and it's bored 20 over. And the guy only had 30 over piston, so I got to rebore the, open up 10 thou on the barrels. But $500 is what it cost me, and he sent me two pistons, no wrist bend, and they are used all right, but they're not in bad shape, but no wrist bend and no clips. Got to get rings, they're 30 over, so if I bore that out 10 thou, these will work. And now, I'm going to try something. I don't know if it'll work or not. That's the other one of the other piston. I've sprayed it with Easy Off oven cleaner, and we'll see how that works on the carbon. I don't know if it'll eat carbon or not. Oh yeah, it eats carbon. It's just going to take a little time. It'll have to sit for a little while. And it's eating the carbon. Easy Off on oven cleaner, works good. Yep, should take the stain right off those pistons. And I don't think it hurts aluminum. I don't think so, anyways, I'm gonna find out, eh? Ah, well. So we'll see how that goes. Now this is just the cheap Easy Off. Best Easy Off, I think, anyways. This is, I don't know, $4. It's in a liquid with a spray, much better than the foam, I think, anyways. We'll see how that works. I'll let you know. No final drive either. And no primary at all. Nothing inside the primary case. I've clutch and everything I've got to take out of my old one and put into this one. Later. I'll show you what I got going on here. Pistons. They were pretty black. Lots of carbon on them. So, what I've been using is Easy Off oven cleaner. Just your cup. And I cleaned one up the other day, but I didn't get inside the ring grooves that well. Don't leave this stuff on too long. It'll turn the aluminum black if you leave it too long. It's awfully hard in the hands if you don't wear rubber gloves. An acid, of course.
see how that darkened that piston real quick. But it will take off carbon very quickly. A little bit of a buff up after you get the carbon off and you've got a nice clean piston. So I would grade it. Agree. Pretty coarse steel wool I'm using here, but it'd be alright. And those are nice, clean landings, real nice. And you do the inside as well. This one I left the darn acid just a little too long. It cleaned it, but this one I did real quickly. About 4 applications of the Easy Off for about 1 minute each application, and then scrub it with a toothbrush. Came out nice and clean, but I left this one a little too long. It turned to black. It won't hurt it. The trick is to get the carbon off. Carbon that's left inside on the bottom of the piston will create a hot spot in that piston. So if you've got, this had really bad blow-by and it had heavy deposits of carbon on the inside, if you left it, or you left just, you know, one spot and said, oh, that's good, well, that one spot on the other side is going to create a hot spot on this side of the piston, you know what I mean? That's when you start blowing holes in pistons. So if you're going to clean up old pistons, you have to clean both the inside and the outside. Otherwise, you're wasting your time. They're not going to shine like new pistons, you know. There, you've got a bit of a gray appearance to them. But they're clean. They're in good shape. This one I was a little more careful with. Did this one this morning, did that one yesterday. Make sure you get all of the Easy Off oven cleaner off of the aluminum. In other words, wash them really, really well. See how it prunes up your fingers? Could strip all the old skin off your hands, that's for sure. Once a piston turns dark like that, you can't get the dark off. You'd have to use a little buffing wheel or something like stainless steel bristles to bring it off, because it's a stain, it just won't come off. Adding more acid won't fix it, in other words. We'll let those dry and see how they look.
Well, I checking the camshafts, they look real good. Real good. There's no play in the rods at all. I think the rod bearings are okay. The rods themselves are good. They're aftermarket, but they're good.
cases are nice. Like I say, there's nothing inside. The primaries are all out. Oh, it does have the adjuster though for the chain, the primary chain, and it looks good yet. That's good. And I have to for the tack, and it's got the oil switch in it, pressure relief. It's a good deal for me because I paid $500 for this and $50 for the two pistons, which I got all cleaned up, and they're in good, really good shape. The two camshafts are $200 a piece, intake and exhaust. That's $400. To get another cover used is $100. That's $500. I needed rods. I needed bottom bearings. Top bearings, well, I'll see. He didn't send me any wrist pins, but Jacques says that he'll find some and send me a set of wrist pins for those bearings, or for those pistons. So all around, it was a good deal. I'm very happy. I'm very happy. The one thing I am going to do is I'm going to break it in half. You see the serial number here on the side, eh? Well, my bike, I have the engine, original engine that matches the frame. I'm going to swap this case with my bike so that it has my, so that the bike will still be registered under that. Sold. It won't be a mismatch. And that's the direction I'll go with that. Let's see where it goes from there. The barrels are, they're okay. They're nothing special. They have the blocks, the guide follower blocks for the cams. They're worth $100. Does have a broken fin, but you can't really see it. Doesn't affect, the bike will still run okay. And it needs a bore job. That's going to cost me a couple of $100 to get it bored and reamed 10,000. Oh well. Yikes, that's hot. She did not budge. Nope.
I think it's gonna let go. Not on this heat, anyways.
Okay. And we'll reheat it again and do it all over again. It costs nothing to heat it in the wood stove. This one might have broke just a fraction, maybe not that or excellent.